It's a glorious sunny day and I've got out on site with Kieran from K Cahill Electrical Contractors. At the property I'm at, he's already installed an in-roof 6 kW solar array, and behind me he's putting together the elements to store that energy. He's got the Growatt Hybrid inverter as well as his DC storage, his bank of batteries. We're going to take a look and have a chat with Kieran and see what he's up to. Thank you for allowing us to come on site with you, Kieran. You're pretty busy at the minute, aren't you?
I'm very busy.
Okay. So what's the first thing we're doing here? So this all looks lots of leads and complicated. So just talk me through what you've got.
We're just prepping for the hybrid to be mounted on the wall. We've got our battery leads here, communication cable for the battery, and our CT cable to measure the current of the property. Basically just getting it all prepped, ready to go, so we can just hang it on the wall, ready to secure it.
And this bit of kit is changing the DC into AC, is that what it is?
Yeah, correct, hybrid inverter? Yeah. And then it can also do doing charges for batteries as well, so it charges them in DC.
And we are about 25 metres away from that solar array, aren't we? Are we bringing DC down in those cables? Yeah, just talk me through what's happening there.
Yeah, we're going to be running them through inside the house, dropping it down so it's in the garage, so it's nice and neatly accessible. That's why we're going to run it all through.
It's a couple of strings, is that right?
Yeah, two string system. So we're going to run two strings from the garage up into the roof and protect them all the way and protect them through. They come into here, trunk it down here and make a nice job of it to make it nice and tidy.
So I step away for a few seconds and already Kieran's got the Growatt on the wall. So at the minute we're just trying to mount some trunking. What's going in the trunking?
Just all our DC pack for the battery, some communication cables, just to dress it so it looks nice and tidy so we can put all our isolators on. So we can isolate our strings, our AC, and we can put some an EPS socket below. So obviously there's emergency power supply also. So yeah, nice and straightforward.
Okay, and we'll come into that EPS socket once we get it mounted to explain what that is. I recognise this isolator as a SCARMI one. We're isolating a couple of things here. Could you just talk me through what we're isolating?
We're isolating the AC that goes back to the fuse board, and we're isolating the two DC strings from the roof to the inverter.
So just to catch you up into real time here, we're about 40 minutes into the install and we're already at the point where we're going to be mounting the battery pack. Kieran, what is the kilowatt rating of the battery pack?
We've got 6.5 kilowatts per cell, so we've got 13 kilowatts in storage in total.
And could we add more if we wanted to?
Yep, we can add more. That's why we put it in the garage, so they can adapt it, so we can add more cells at a later date. Lock it in.
I almost couldn't keep up with you there, so we just dropped you onto the bracket and you're locking it in. Just show me that locking in mechanism.
You literally have the little catches here, which just stops it from falling forward so it's solid as a rock.
And that is it fitted?
Yep, fitted.
So we're connecting it to the leads above here and you're just going to route them through the trunking and then that's it?
Yep, ready to go.
So second one on the wall.
Lovely. Ready to rock. Just dressing the cables into the trunking.
Okay, and these are going to connect straight to the battery?
Yep, they click straight in.
So the trunking for you is cosmetic in the majority of cases?
Just protection, so it maintains the cables are not going to get damaged, or any little kiddies are going to get their fingers in.
Okay, so pop those through there, and then it's just a simple case of connecting to the battery?
Connecting the battery, yep. And literally just click it in.
Oh, wow.
And click it in. And then we can just lose the remaining in the trunking, just to make it look nice and pretty.
Another set over here for the first battery. So if we were going for more than two cells or two batteries, we'd obviously have another set.
We can adapt it, yeah, we can change the leads over so we can get different leads so we can adapt for it, yeah.
So we've got a black one and an orange one. Just talk me through why we've got two different colours.
Just positive and negative, that's all for the batteries.
And what colour are they using for positive then?
Positive is the orange lead.
Okay, so of course we always think of red and black, don't we? So we've got orange and black.
I've just put in the CAN cable now in to link up to the batteries.
So this is communication, so it's data, is it?
It's just to transmit a signal so then the battery knows what to do. So it's discharging or charging. So it's just to indicate what it does, this little unit here.
Okay, and that's got an RJ45 end on it?
It's an RJ45 end on, yeah.
But it's not as if it's giving it internet connection?
No, it's not, no. It's just a communication, so it just lets the battery know what's going on, basically.
Okay, so you wiggle that one through. And you've also linked them together as well,
haven't
you?
I've linked them together, so then they discharge and charge in sequence of each other. So they're all communicating together.
So that's it. So just show me the linking cable being the one.
So the linking cable is this one here. Obviously, I have to put a little port in here just to close the circuit from here to into the link in this side here.
So we've got a meter here.
So yeah, so the PV will be feeding the meter and the output will be going back to the fuse board into the property.
Okay, and this is a requirement. We have to have this, don't we?
Yeah, for MCS regulations, yep. So you can get, also you can register for the for your export tariff.
So that means being paid to export energy. However, looking at the batteries here, we're trying to keep that energy, aren't we? Because we might be getting 5, 6, 7p for exporting and then buying it back later in the evening at 30 pence or something ridiculous.
Yeah, correct. Like literally, I'm just plugging the AC in now, and it's as simple as that.
So that's the AC output, AC here, output, which goes via a switch in the meter, doesn't it?
Yep.
So that's in and connected, and the other end of that's the one that we're going to see connected in
into
the consumer unit at some point. Any other connections in here that we're going to concentrate on next? I see you've fitted a socket here. What's that socket all about?
This is now for the emergency power supply. We're just going to run an EPS supply from the inverter.
So just tell us what EPS stands for.
Emergency power supply.
So in the event of a complete power cut, this socket outlet that
you're going to install? This socket outlet will become live, yep. So the customer will have a power supply to run an extension lead and power their internal appliances in their house.
Okay. Could we do anything more elaborate with that? Could we have dedicated circuits in the house run on that?
So what we can do, we can actually put a contactor in and then put designated circuits in the property via the contactor, so we can use some of the circuits to be powered via the battery system.
So if they had like a chair lift, you'd obviously make that a priority circuit that would come on in the event of power failure, it'd still work.
Yeah, all their lights, and the sockets that Wi-Fi, sockets that the customer needs to be useful.
I like that one, Wi-Fi. Yeah, so we've got a chair lift or Wi-Fi, we'll pick the Wi-Fi. Okay, makes sense. So that they've got one socket in this system here, this twin socket here. If any of a power failure, could have like a fridge or a freezer in this garage area, we're plugged in there, would be permanently then on.
Yep. This is just the EPS lead. I'm literally just going to put it into the output and then run it down to the double socket. So.
So you've made that a bit of flex, obviously you've
made a nice bit of flex.
A plug on the end of it.
Just nice and easy to make off. Yeah,
clip it straight into position.
Clip it into position.
Okay, so, and then the other end just
and that'll run down into the socket, ready to go.
And that one will be on all the time when the power's off.
Yep. This is the clamp, the CT clamp. This measures the current in the property. So this will tell us when the batteries need to discharge.
Does it matter which of the tails you go on?
It goes onto the live conductor, always face the arrow, always facing towards the sun.
You see that arrow on there?
See it on there? Just inside the middle.
Okay, yeah.
So yeah, it just goes on in here like this.
That clips and holds itself in
clips
position.
On in position, like that, yep. And then we'll just dress the cable back up and over.
So we've had some fun together pulling the strings in and they're rooted round into the roof space. And you brought the two sets down to here for the isolator. We've got to identify which one's which, or do we know which one's positive and which
we're
one's negative?
We're going to test them so we can get them all to get the correct polarity.
Okay, and then from the isolator, obviously, we go into the Growatt. That's a juicy connection there for the earth. Just talk me through that.
So literally, we just got to earth the batteries down. So literally, because they're all class one, so making sure everything's earthed correctly. Linking both together to the inverter itself.
And they come pre-made, those leads,
don't
they, in the kit?
They come pre-made, ready to go, yep.
So the strings are single core 6mm.
Yep.
And obviously we need to be able to isolate them. Just remind me why I need to be able to turn off the DC coming off the panels.
It's just a form of maintenance, and in case of an emergency, we can isolate them from here. So just to make safe and stuff like that.
So these isolators are for DC. Is there anything special about a DC isolator compared to an AC one?
A DC isolator is rated for the current, as it jumps a lot, DC current opposed to AC. So they're rated for that. So if it had an AC, if you just put an AC isolator on a DC cable, essentially it could actually burn out. It's not rated for it.
Currently looking for strings off the roof and the cables that we've brought in so we can bring them together. Any precautions with the ones from the roof?
Just make sure, obviously, not touching each other, and just be very careful. Obviously, when you're making them off, just make them off one at a time, and just be very careful.
And just for those people who are watching this, why you got to be careful with the ones coming off the solar panels?
Obviously, with daylight, solar is always panels are always live, so just be careful.
The minute that panel went on the roof and it's in daylight, it's actually always live, isn't it?
Correct. Yeah. Ready to go.
And that's so we can join the strings together.
Yeah, I might tuck that back down in that felt actually. I'll try and Turn this down a little bit more.
One set, obviously, this set here is live, isn't it?
Yeah, it's live, yeah. So you've just got to be ultra careful when you're stripping it back.
Is that why you stagger them as well?
So that's why I stagger them, yeah. So you don't touch them together.
And what's the saying you've been using all day, which I really like about crossing the summing others?
Don't cross the strings.
Okay, and we've had a...
Don't cross the streams.
A big conversation about Ghostbusters as well today. So we're stripping those back. Obviously, they're different lengths, they can't touch. If they do touch, what we like to see?
A big spark.
Okay, because obviously those panels are permanently live when there's light falling on the roof and it's a bright sunny day. You're going to do a little test for me now?
Yep, we're going to do a little test.
What's this going to prove?
Just test which one's live and positive, and we've got a feed, and we've got 292 minus volts. So the positive is in the left hand on my negative test lead.
Okay. So if you'd have had the leads the other way around, we would have not had it as a negative showing, is that
correct?
Right?
Correct, yep.
Yeah. So now we're going to join these together with a little crimp, and then there's a plug and play system, isn't there?
Yep, it's called MC4 crimper. I'm using MC4 crimper tool.
Yep.
Just to make sure the connections are nice and sound and not going anywhere.
So this goes on the end and then effectively becomes the plug and play system.
Yep, so literally put this like this, like that, and they are solid, so it's not going anywhere.
Okay, and then there's the rest of the housing to go on.
Yep. Plug it in.
And you do that four times, so two on each?
Yep, two on each, so they're all ready to go, ready to plug in, job done.
Yeah,
you've got to use MC4 crimpers. If you use anything else, it's dangerous.
So yeah, these are slightly different to the crimping tools.
These are slightly different because the teeth, there's a little lip that bends over and that causes this to happen, the bend, so then it gets a solid connection, so they're not going absolutely anywhere.
And because we left our isolators in the off position down at the mains end where we've got our battery setup, etc., we're obviously not got an issue with going live there either, have we, at the moment?
No, it's all safe.
I just clip them together.
Clip them together, like so.
And lock into position. And then again, we've got the ability to, if we had some maintenance, we could disconnect them from here, remove the panels off the roof, couldn't we?
Yep, exactly that.
Okay, so we haven't got a rip out, obviously, the continuous wiring system down to our batteries. Obviously, that would be a huge amount of cable to take out, wouldn't it, for that process? So they're connected there. There's some stickers to go on now, isn't there?
Yep.
So these are the indication stickers, are they?
Yep. I'm up here so you can see them.
Ah, right, so a bit like your luggage at an airport.
Luggage at an airport, just indicating what's what. To be fair, I'll save that one for the other one.
Okay. So there should be no confusion that that is not a Sky TV.
No. Yes, we'll go downstairs and start firing up.
More labels?
Yep, more labels. We're just labeling up the main isolator. This isolates the AC to the hybrid unit.
Up to there. Any more to do while we're here?
Yep, we've got to do, an inverter label. So we've got to label the inverter up.
So labeling that. Just explaining what that is, yeah?
Yep, just explaining what the unit is.
Okay. I don't think we'll get confused with a gas boiler, would we?
No.
Any more?
Yep, we've got some DC isolators. So PV array DC isolator. So we've got to do this one.
So there's two of those?
Two of those. Don't sometimes fit the best, but then we'll try.
Okay, so that's there. One of our DC strings. And then obviously we'll do the one next to it. Do you label the cables that come out of the bottom of the Growatt? So these black ones here, which obviously are part of our strings, do you ever label those?
Yeah, we're going to label these ones with a DC mains voltage string as well. So obviously these are always live during sunlight.
Which so that's similar to what we just see in the roof,
yep,
then, yeah?
Exactly.
Same sort
that,
of idea, yep.
So we'll label these up, and we'll make them off, then we'll label them up. So basically we're just putting a sticker on to indicate there's PV on the roof so everyone knows the solar panels on it.
Okay, that's well, I've got solar panel sticker, is that what it's all about? So look at me, I've got solar panels, or is there a better reason for putting that right by the mains end, Kieran?
It's just an indicator, so obviously if people are isolating stuff, there's still an indication that there's live cables potentially coming back through to the mains.
So if I'm working in the consumer unit where the supply comes into it, it could be live from the top of the circuit breaker, is that right?
Correct, yeah, so it's just a good way of indicating. It's on the one up here. Have a look in our spare way here so we can isolate them correctly and lock off the appropriate breakers to make sure everything's safe.
So because you've got two sources of energy, it's not I've got a nice solar array, it's actually a sticker that's required.
Yeah.
This one here?
Just another one as well, just an indication. If anyone's working with it, you can sign it and isolate the mains.
Are we going to measure the voltage at this end as well?
Yeah, we're just going to measure it now to make sure what voltage we've got here. So we've got 295 volts. So upstairs we've got 296. So we've just lost 1 volt.
And that was about a 25-meter run that we put in?
Yeah, correct, yeah.
So people shouldn't worry about the volt drop from those panels, should they?
No, not from that distance, no.
the same process as what we see in the roof space. We might be able to see a little bit clearer now this crimping action, won't we?
Yep, so we're going to actually, all we do, we've tested out when we've turned our string on, tested which is positive and negative. We literally just slide on the MC4 crimp there, get our crimpers, just like that. And that makes a solid connection, ready to go.
And the rest of it, and then obviously just plug and play again.
Plug and play, yeah.
But this time we're actually going to go into the unit itself.
Yeah, into the inverter itself.
Are they polaritised there as well?
Yeah, they have got to be polarity conscious, so the system will not operate with this sort of wrong polarity.
So which one you've just put in there?
That's the negative, yep. That's the positive. Okay. And I'll label these up with some tape as well, so brown and grey.
So we'll do that for both sets, and then are we ready to, we're ready to rumble?
Yeah, we're going to do the other set now, so if we just measure this off and I'll zip tie these up neatly.
And this is where you said you'll add another one of those stickers, even though it's only coming out a short
Yeah,
span.
We just identify all the time, just to let everyone know what it is and what it's doing, so.
Strip that set off, twist them up. Single core, one's positive, one's negative. Join them together into the Growatt, and I think we'll be going, yeah, we'll be going live, will we?
Yeah, not far off.
So one more label here then.
Yeah, one more label. I'm gonna just wrap this round DC strings to indicate. I don't want each one, so it's a little bit easier. So what does what?
Let me stick that one on again, indicating that when light is on the roof, they will be live.
They will be live indeed. Yeah, lovely. So they're all indicated, ready to go.
So we're going to turn it on?
Yep, we're going to turn it on. We're going to literally just flick these cells on. We'll turn these strings on.
So you turn the strings on from underneath and the two isolators. So actually there's three ways of isolation.
Three ways of isolation, yeah.
So you could isolate it from there.
You can isolate the array from here, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Just to have a little see and see what we're... we've isolated the AC at the moment just to see. Okay. And get these batteries charging off grid.
Ah, so we're off grid. So we are not putting this into the property.
No,
we're
not at the moment. It's just showing. It'll say no. It might come up with a warning line. Just indicating there's no AC present, but this will come up in a minute and it'll start charging the batteries.
You're showing me two panels on the left-hand side, is that because
there is
two?
Yeah, both strings, both working correctly, yeah.
And there's that voltage we saw, wasn't it?
So yeah, now it's going to check in and it's going to go into charging mode, which it's doing now.
So that is now charging, yeah?
Any minute now, it'll just go into charge mode. There we go, and the batteries are charging. If you look at the batteries...
Okay, well, you see a nice flashing LED, aren't
we? Nice flashing green free energy charging into these from the sunlight.
And then with a little leaf as well. Do we know what rate we're going into the batteries at?
I believe it's 1200 watt per string we're generating at.
Okay, let's have a little look. Yeah.
1200 and 750 volts
there. Into those batteries, so that's nice free energy from sunlight.
Yeah, yeah.
So as you get to the end of this video, hopefully you're deciding whether a solar array and battery storage is for you, or you were intrigued by the process. However, Kieran, what are they saying to you when they ring you up, and how long does this installation actually take to do?
This installation is an in-roof 16-panel integrated system. So we've had a team of roofers here, myself today doing the connections, testing the array, making sure everything's tickety-boo this end. So 2 days start to finish process, all in, done.
2 days, that's the moment that I wanted to hear from Kieran. 2 days to do this install. And would you say it's a process that customers should be worried about, or what I've seen today, it's actually quite a straightforward system, isn't
it? Not at all. So it's an easy process. We work all the way from the beginning, set up the processes, how we're going to do it, set the scaffolding right, everything like that. So it's not a nice, straightforward process.
And there's also an app at the end to control the system for the customer as well. But as we stand here with the batteries behind us, they're fully charging up at the minute, but also, we're running the house as well, aren't we?
Correct, yeah. So we've got enough surplus power to feed into the house and also feed into our battery cells.
I'd like to thank you, Kieran. I've had a great day.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Cheers, bud.